You're my special friend.
Can everyone say hi to my friend?
Back from the dead.
Boom! It's the moment you've all been waiting for. The moment to see me. No, I'm kidding, of course. You have other things to do, important things to do. This is our special time where we get to hang out and talk movies. Now, I thought I was done with Vinegar Syndrome because I'm about to switch over heavy into Severance stuff to prepare for that sale. By the way, live coverage coming towards the end of next week because this weekend is Scream Weekend. I'll explain that later. But we have Partner Month for June from Vinegar Syndrome. Let's discuss all the titles. And to help me do that, none other than the man, the myth, the legend, the one we all call brother, Brother Chaos.
Hey, everybody. How's everybody doing out there? Thanks for having me. How are you?
I'm pretty sure everyone's doing good. I'm doing great. Thanks for hanging in. I know you're under the weather, so I appreciate you hanging in there.
Yeah, I have. I woke up with a cold. I have pain in my throat. A lot of mucus on my inside my nose and a little bit of a
headache.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Well, thanks for the descriptions. hope you feel better. Hopefully, the titles we'll talk about today will make you feel better. I know there's one that we're going to start with. Actually, that was a title we bonded over. So yeah, we'll definitely get to that in a moment. But let me check in with the chat. How is everybody doing? Fett in the house. Hope there's good stuff. There is indeed. Tony will be joining us a little later. He's running behind, but he wanted us to know that he has a belly button. What do you think about that? What do you think about his belly button?
I don't know. I don't think about it.
I don't think about it either. Nobody really should. Bullet Blake says he's got two thumbs. Very good.
Oh, good.
Bill Keys, hello. Wow, Erdal from the catalog, probably Correda's most obscure work. So obscure that it's such an outlier from the rest of his filmography. I didn't even know he directed the film at first. I'm going to be talking about that. I'm a big Correda fan, so I'm very curious about Erdal. I may just blind buy that, but I'm scared to blind buy. I've just been burnt so much in the past. It just doesn't work for me anymore. How about you, BC? Are you more scared of blind buying than you were back in the day?
Yeah, a little bit more, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, it's called Dark Tower. It's called Tough Guys Don't Dance. All those things.
Yes, yes, it is.
Traumatizing. Oh, Razor, hello to you. Midlife Media, what's up, dude? I should have you on soon. We should do a collab. Hey, Vin Cinephile, what a name. New to the channel, welcome. I'm happy to have you here as well.
Hello.
Planet Mondo, legendary duo at the moment, but trio forthcoming. Drink some Bullet Bourbon, BC. It'll clear that right up.
Oh, is it expensive?
No, it isn't. I think it's like $30 a bottle, but
that's not bad.
No, you're not supposed to drink it in a week. You kind of take a shot every once in a while.
I wouldn't drink it in a week. No.
Yeah. Probably some people can kill it in a night, but they shouldn't. Nerd of the 80s, hi everyone. I missed out on the Franco. You know what? I had a chance to buy it, but I'll bring it up later. But the reason I didn't buy it, this slip, great slip, and I love Brigitte LaHaye so much, beautiful woman. But I can't have this slip hanging around the house. and it's a Just Franco movie. I'm not a big Just Franco guy, but I don't know. I do love this slip, but yeah, nah, can't have that on the house. You probably wouldn't have picked that up too, right, BC? I know you like Franco.
Franco is hit or miss, really. I wouldn't blind buy a Franco title. I mean, I might, but lately I gotta make sure what I buy.
The one Franco title I will recommend that everybody does buy during the Severance sale is the Franco Noirs. They're not, I mean, if you're into Franco for the vagina close-ups, there's nothing in there for you, but it's two really solid scripts and very well-directed movies. So if you like noir films, that shows that he's actually a real filmmaker, and I love that.
Oh, Master Chaos, are you going to mention what you picked up from Scream Factory, or is that another video?
Well, I haven't talked about that, but yeah, I picked up the Chucky set, the Chucky 4K set. I didn't get the one with the pins and the postcards, but I did get the one with the charred doll, because fucking yeah, I needed that.
It looks awesome, yeah.
And I, you know, I talk about how I don't like 4K upgrades, but I don't like forced 4K upgrades as a subscriber. If Vinegar Syndrome had put out the Chucky movies, holy fuck, that would have been so amazing. I would have been so happy with that.
Yeah.
But, you know, 4K upgrade of Death Wish 2 that I'm forced to get, and it doesn't do anything for me.
And I think that Child's Play set comes to like 5 posters or something crazy like that.
Yeah, 5 posters and the toy, and then two different slipcovers for 2 and 3. So
yeah, that's awesome. Exciting.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
What were you going to say? You can finish it. Your thought?
Oh, no. I don't remember now.
Okay. Griff, evening to you, sir. It has been a while. Bullet Blake says, Tough Guys Don't Dance was fantastic. I'm glad you enjoyed it, my friend. I'm glad you enjoyed it. The 100. Hey, guys, how's it going? Going well, my friend. Let's see. Midlife says, only thing I bought was Jebrul de Partout, which was the porn. But I think I'll pick up Video Violence 1 and 2 soon. We're going to be talking about Video Violence. As a matter of fact, why don't we switch over there?
All right.
Because that is what we've all come here. And I will address comments as they come in. There's a whole bunch I haven't gotten to yet, but I will get to them. Sorry, YouTube. There's no way to censor the boobage there. So enjoy the nip while it can be shown. It is, of course, a free country still. And I'm not monetized, so I don't have to worry about that. Let's start at the bottom, the last release, and the one that's really the most exciting for Brother Chaos and I, and that is Video Violence. Why don't you share a little bit about our history of Video Violence?
Oh, I remember us watching it and having a good time because it was so gory, and we were new to shot on video films. And this was around the time when we watched stuff by the Polonia brothers and John McBride, namely Splatter Farm and Cannibal Campout, stuff like that. And this one was another shot on video, Gore Fest, that was very entertaining, lots of fun. I didn't know you liked it as much as I did. I remember you liking it, but I didn't know that you liked it as much as I did. I have the DVD, but I would gladly upgrade to the blue.
I mean, shot on video, you gotta upgrade the blue, because then it really pops. Complete irony there, sarcasm, I should say. You know what? I didn't love it as much as you did, and I'll be the first person to say they're not great movies, but, and I wish I could flash a butt like I normally do for my edited videos, but, they have a good memory for me. They hold a dear place in my heart because of our bonding over shot on video movies. I remember we had seen Cannibal Campout, and we're like, holy shit, this is a masterpiece of shit. And we love it so much. And then we discovered Video Violence, I think in the same video store, maybe another one, but we watched it and I didn't think it was as strong. It's definitely more satirical. It feels very much like, speaking of a sale title for Vinegar Syndrome, it feels like Death Row Game Show in a way, but with snuff tape. Okay.
Yeah.
So I didn't like it as much, but I love the memory behind the movies. And I think nostalgia does sell a lot of these things.
Mm-hmm.
So objectively, if somebody were to tell me, are these good movies? I'd say, no, they're not great, but they're charming. They're fun, and honestly, of the recent shot on video movies on the site, I would say Video Violence is at least the most entertaining and the most creative, and definitely, I think, the most bang for your buck. And we will be buying this for sure. I already bought mine, actually.
Awesome.
And it is a slipcase case, kind of like Ticks and Dead Heat, so you'll get a slipcase, and then we don't know what the inner slipcase will look like, but it looks like it's going to be like the video store. It's about a video store that rents snuff movies, essentially. That's the plot on that one. Cult Flicks, what's up, man? Good to see you in here. Adam says, video violence 1 and 2 are a must. I am excited. I'm so happy that you're excited. It really is amazing. And I knew this was coming. I mean, they Terrorvision announced this months ago, almost at the beginning of the year. So I was very excited for Video Violence to show up, just like I was very excited for Mr. Tony the Dead to show up.
Unfucking believable, man.
What's up, man? Okay.
Yeah, it's just nobody gives a fuck about me, about my time. That's all.
What? Oh, no.
No, not you guys. Not you guys.
Oh, okay. Okay. No okay. Good. Well, I'm glad you're here with us, man. And have you had a chance to look at the partner labels?
The only thing I did was I skimmed real quick to see if this was true about video violence. That's the thing I kind of like looked at. I was like, okay, cool.
Awesome. We just started here, actually, because it's the one that's the most interesting to me and BC, and it sounds like you're interested in it. Are you aware of this? Have you seen this before?
Oh, yeah. That's like my favorite shot on video.
Awesome.
Yep. Awesome. Fantastic.
Hi, BC.
What's
up? Somebody brings up a good point, though. Hoke says, very pricey for non-subs. It is very expensive. I mean, it is, you know, almost $48. Your half off price is $35. That's what the subscribers get it for, and come Black Friday, that's what you're gonna be able to get it for, if you're gonna wait for the discount. Will it last till Black Friday? I'm gonna say yes. I think at that price, I don't think it's gonna move very fast. I think we've seen Terrorvision titles hold out for a long time. So if you want to wait for Black Friday, wait for Black Friday, but you are still paying $35 for two shot on video movies. However, historically, they are important to the shot on video world.
So I think it would
be a much more worthy purchase than like fucking, what's that Hobo Woman movie?
That wasn't that great.
No. Oh, there you go. Nice. The Cam Motion Pictures version. Nice.
That's the same one that I have, Tony.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was in a contest too, and I ended up winning the big box thing that has the VHS tapes in it and a shirt and sticker and that.
Oh, awesome.
That's in the other room though. But yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah, had you seen it before that DVD or cool. Yeah. Were you able to rent it on VHS?
No, I know about it back in the day. I don't know how I found out about it, to be honest. Probably Camp Motion Pictures. I was probably on their website. And I was like, oh, what's this? And I watched. I was like, oh, my God, I love this movie.
Oh, it's great. Yeah.
What do you think about the sequel? I thought the sequel was fun as well. Not as solid as the first one, but it was still a lot of fun.
Not as good, yeah.
Yeah, agreed. Yeah. First one's so much better. But yeah. I still like the second one, though, but not as much.
Right, same here.
Still worth it, yeah. I'm glad that they included it and they didn't make you pay for a second one down the road.
Yeah.
Now, Brad had mentioned on another stream, actually, that the special features are not finished, so there's more coming. Usually they like to stack them, so we're going to be getting more than just an interview with Paige Price, interview with Mark Dolson and Mark Kwiatek. An interview with Robert D'Amico, and then SOV's That Wouldn't Die Doc, which I imagine is a feature length doc, but I don't know. But that's
awesome. That would be awesome if it were feature length. That would be awesome.
Yeah.
Documentary on SOV. I thought there was one, but that 100% needs to happen. Let's see. There's not much in the plot, but I'll tell you what it says here. A husband and wife open a video store in a new town and come to find out that the locals only rent horror films and the occasional triple Xer. And make their own snuff videos. A very fun movie. 165 minutes combined. That's kind of crazy. I thought they were fairly short. But there it is. Finally, on Blu-ray. restored as best as it could, I would imagine. Video Violence, man. I am excited. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy that it's out. I'm getting BCs. Tony, have you grabbed this already?
No, I haven't grabbed anything yet.
Gotcha.
I looked and saw how many was left, and I was like, okay, I'm safe.
Oh, yeah.
You never know. When you saw, like, oh, okay, you think this one's safe, and then, like, all of a sudden, it's like 900 some left. What do they know that we don't?
Two titles have already sold out, actually, and there was probably two titles that you would have wanted.
Really?
Yeah, let me show you the slipcovers. They were only at 1,000. And this was the slipcover.
Oh, shit.
And then this was the back of it. they're gone. I actually had a chance to buy it, but I can't have that slip in the house. So I passed. And there was no option without it. So there's no way to get that one now. But I think you can buy it through the Pulse website, you know, the French porn site.
Yeah. Well, I have those other two. I never even watched them. So I guess if I don't get it, I don't really care.
You'll survive, right?
I'll survive.
At the end of the day, it's all gravy.
They might find it in a hidden box in the warehouse.
Maybe. Well, VS. Oh yeah, VS does do that a couple times. That's true.
Oh God.
Let's see. Let me close this and check out the chat real quick. They're probably the best SOV films, though. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. That, and I would consider Cannibal Camp Out only because it was the first one and it made such an impression on us.
Yeah.
That's, oh yeah, definitely.
A great film.
It's so bad, it's good.
Yeah. Terrorvision seems to be pricey with the releases in general. Yeah, I'm not sure what the thinking is there. Mike Ricky, unfortunately, his grandpa's diapers were too expensive this month, so he's gonna need to wait a bit.
Oh,
sorry to hear that, pal. But they'll last for Black Friday. Oh, remember, by the way, if you use the $5 coupon, don't buy anything today. Wait until June 10th because you're getting a $10 coupon. And then you can get Real Violent for $37. Mm-hmm. A little change there if you want to do it that way. I want to make sure people remember.
What coupon are you talking about?
There was a $5 coupon that they sent in an email. You didn't buy anything, so you didn't use it. But you didn't buy directly through the site. But if you bought something, you could apply $5, and then they said they would send you a $10 coupon. And on June 10th for Partner Month.
Okay.
That was definitely a selling point for a lot of people. I know a lot of people went back in just to use that $5. Let's see. Hoke says, now we need Woodchipper Massacre. We do.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
That's a lot of fun. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but it's not, in my memory, it's not that gory, but it's funny as hell. I enjoyed it. It's a fun one.
I haven't seen that in a long time.
That's one of my earlier reviews on my channel.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Oh, my gosh. Witcher Massacre was the first shot on video movie I ever bought on DVD. I love it, too. All right.
Awesome.
A whole bunch of fans.
Great. I don't own it. I wish I did.
Well, maybe we'll get it on Blu-ray. We'll see. They are manufacturing some FOMO with limited slips movies this time around. Maybe more now than ever. Yep. Because they know it will sell. Midlife. I bought an SLV recently from Severin. Hey, Stop Stabbing Me, and it was awesome. Loved it. I just saw that last night. Fantastic. Very funny movie. I'm actually going to have the writers and director on the show eventually, maybe sometime later in June. They also, believe it or not, are the writers for the Sonic the Hedgehog movies.
No, wow. Really?
Okay.
That's so awesome.
Talk about making out okay in Hollywood. That's amazing.
quite a change.
yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Brian says, "What's the AGFA titles?" Well, let's go there. Let's open up the page here. AGFA title. To be honest, 100% honest, the rest of the month is kind of meh to me. It nothing super jumps out. There's stuff I will buy, but nothing that really jumps out as I go, oh yeah. So you can still see the slip over here in the corner, Tony. But I can't censor that. So YouTube, too bad. Too bad, so sad. All right, let's start. Should we go in? Well, let's start at the top. We'll go with Air Doll.
By the way, my I believe my Halfway to Friday order shipped already.
Nice.
It says tomorrow, but I doubt it. It'll probably be Monday.
That's awesome.
But everything says fulfilled. So there's probably stuff I ordered beforehand and in the sale. So it's going to be a huge box. So I'll be doing an unboxing. I didn't mean to cut you off.
No. That's good. That's amazing. Mine is coming. It was supposed to be here Saturday. I just checked and now it says Sunday. So fuck. Hopefully it'll be in time. I can do it. I'll do the unboxing.
Yeah.
For Monday. But yeah. I didn't order a lot of stuff, so that's why it got to me fairly quicker than normal. This is a sex doll. What you're looking at right here is not a human being. This is, I mean, it's just a human being. But in the movie, she's supposed to be a sexy doll. Normally, I don't love when the back is plain, but the last few movies I've gotten with a plain back have been awesome. So maybe see how she looks like in the movies is different. So maybe that's the reverse of butt on the back. Plain kind of back.
Yeah.
I hope so. Anyway, this looks right up your alley, BC. I think it's something you might enjoy.
I would watch it, but I wouldn't try before I buy if it's available somewhere to see. But I doubt it. But I wouldn't blind buy it.
Gotcha. All right, let me read you the little story here. A present-day fable for the increasing disconnect we feel in urban life. Hirokazu Koreeda's Air Doll transports the Galatea myth to present-day Tokyo. A life-size air doll, Bei Duna, from The Host, lives in a shabby apartment in Tokyo. She cannot speak, nor can she move. Pfft, sign me up! No, I'm just kidding. but she is the only companion her middle-aged master has. Oh, perfect. He talks to her, puts her in a bath, and makes love with her every day after he returns from work. This routine life is disrupted when fantasy turns into reality. The air doll suddenly comes to life, filled with a soul. Like a newborn baby, she doesn't understand what is going on around her. So it's kind of like a sexy Encino Man. maybe? I don't know. But she sees a world waiting to be explored outside the apartment, eventually venturing to the outside world. The air doll is fascinated by everything she sees. Though she meets many people in all walks of life, they can't seem to provide her an answer to what being alive means. When the air doll wanders into a video store, her world is forever changed. She meets Junichi, the clerk, and immediately falls in love with him. The air doll begins working in the store, and every day she and Junichi become closer. They go to the movies and explore the city together like a couple. Everything is going perfect for the air doll until one day when her hand is accidentally cut off and she begins to deflate in Junichi. A romantic fantasy that explores the complexities of love and loss, joy and pain, fantasy and reality. This bittersweet love story examines the intricacies of and frailties of human existence, adapted from a manga. Holy crap, that's a lot. An inflatable sex doll comes to life. It's mannequin by way of Korea. Oh, no, Japan. That's right. A Japanese mannequin. BC, I'll start with you. Does that sound interesting to you?
It sounds interesting. It does. Yeah, I would like to see it. I don't know about blind buying it, though, but I would like to see it.
Oh, man. Should we watch a trailer? Let's see if I can pull up a trailer here.
Oh, yeah, that would be cool.
Tony, tell us your feelings on this title. Is this something that you would plop down good money to watch a lonely Japanese man have sex with an air doll?
I paid more for less, so yeah.
Oh, amazing. okay. all right, so is this a solid buy for you, sir?
Yeah, I think unless the trailer looks terrible, but yeah, it sounds interesting. Especially it cuts her hand off and she starts deflating. It's like, what? It sounds interesting.
It can happen, man. It's sad. Oh man,
that's all I need to do.
What happens to the original owner of the doll? Does he get jealous that she's falling in love with another guy?
I mean,
hopefully she's new off the shelf.
I mean, I would imagine that's the plot, you know, that he's jealous that, you know, she's like dating this other dude and exploring the world without him. Yeah, I mean, that does sound quite interesting. It does feel very different from the other films that dude has made. It feels very modern, but yeah, Air Doll, what's everybody thinking in the chat? We're going to watch the trailer in a moment here. Francis says, LOL, you had me at starts deflating. and Brian says, where can you buy this doll? They didn't. They didn't include a special doll, which is interesting. But hey, Wet Movie, what's up, buddy? I'll be seeing you tomorrow. Wet Movie and I are going to a horror convention tomorrow where we're going to meet the Screamcast. Oh, fuck yeah. We're going to meet Neve Campbell, Skeet Ulrich, Matthew Lillard, and Jamie Kennedy. Very excited.
Nice. Cool.
Very, very excited for that. Blake says, I didn't grab this one, to be honest. Well, let's see if a trailer will change your mind. Or maybe it won't. But only one way to find out. Air Doll.
Dare no kakete mise maattoru motonnen na. Hunma yakutadaze. Ore yori mitsu shita chau kana.
Wow. Oh, Jesus. I guess so, except the real girl that never comes to life. Oh, awesome. Look at that video store. I never saw Sensei.
年を取るってどういうこと？
命を失うこと。
私も空っぽなの。
今だけはみんなそうだろう。
みんな？
ああ、特にこんな町に住んでる人たちや。
命はその中に欠如を抱く。
He did Plato in the vagina?
Oh my god!
Kokoro nante motana kereba yokatta.
Urushii.
Bicentennial man.
Yeah. Hurry, inflate him in the vagina!
Moto no ningyo ni modotte kure henka?
It seems like a sweet porn movie.
世界は多分他者の相和。しかし互いに欠如を満たすなどと知りもせず。
Are there two things talking? It seems like there's two things talking. It's kind of weird. Interesting. Wet Movie says movie looks interesting. I can't lie. I agree. BC, what do you think?
Look, I was expecting it to be a little bit more sleazy, but it seems like it's more a little bit classier.
It does.
With the whole doll experiencing humanity. So
yeah, it does seem like
philosophical questions.
it seems like a really like sweet meaning of life movie and not about some sweaty Japanese guy having sex with a rubber doll.
Yeah, you know, that would have been more cool to me.
He's honest.
The opposite for me. I'm gonna blind buy that shit right now. Bucket of Blood says, why does this actually look well acted and sweet? I guess it is. Surprisingly. Blake says, looks interesting, but at the same time, looks kind of boring. Glad I passed.
Oh, okay.
I can't blame it. Adam is sold. Adam's going to grab a copy. 100 says, Air Doll looks all right. It's by the same director who did Shoplifters, which is pretty damn good. Yeah, Corey, that's a fantastic filmmaker. Brian Trash is into it. Francis says, it looks too good. I'm out. Like BC, like if it was like a sweaty, weird, like, and he was like slobbering over the rubber boobs, you'd be like, yeah, give me two copies.
Yeah,
best movie of the year contender right there.
Oh my god.
Jiao Jia, creepy and bittersweet. Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it. Very strange. Wet Movie says BC likes this because it's a movie about his life. No,
he was the doll.
Wet Movie one, why do you go there?
Why do you go there? You're not supposed to know about that.
You're not supposed to talk about that.
Yeah, he told you in secret about his secret wife.
I know, man.
Oh my god.
Francis says, I'm with BC. I think people would have appreciated a dirty version. So does Blake as well. Trashy low budget version instead.
Yes.
All right. Well, yeah. I, you know what? I'm sold. And if it's good, BC, you can borrow it, and just watch the parts where the she's like laying naked on the bed. All right. Let's talk about the title that I'm. Well, I won't say the least interested in, but definitely the one that had my hopes going for such a long time, only to dash them against the fucking rock. Limited edition is sold out? Oh, that's interesting. Oh, well, okay. Not buying it anyway. Apocalypse After, you may already have this because Mondo Macabro put this out.
I don't have it.
I don't know why. I don't know how, honestly. Altered Innocence got their hands on it, and Mondo was able to put a version of it out. I'm guessing it's the same thing. I don't have that version. I'm not interested in it. It was this image that they teased, and I'm like, oh, shit, it's going to be Shockma. It's going to be Shockma. Shockma is one of my fucking favorite crazy monster animal movies.
Yeah.
Not Shockma. It's not Shockma. It's is this even, I don't know if it's American. I'm not sure where. I don't think it is. I think it's French. I'll read the description in a minute. But it's essentially a collection of short films. I'm already not interested.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I don't. Oh, 500 units for the slipcover. Wow, that went fast. Weird. Yeah, not interested in the. Actually, you know what? There's a lot of complicated names here. Tony, would you mind reading this for us?
You fucker. Aging starlets fight over a gross piece of flesh that inspires sexual devotion. A woman finds inspiration in the animation of dead animals. A certain Valerian
Borkowski or something like that.
B makes his way through a cruel life, and a transgressive director keeps searching for films that will make her spectators' hearts turn into their thoracic cages like a steak on a grill. From the visionary director of The Wild Boys and After Blue comes a collection of 3+ hours of short works that will ensnare your senses and leave you desperate for more of the wonderful and weird world of Bernard Mandico.
Yeah, I'm not sure. It doesn't say it here, but I'm not sure. I think it's in, oh, there you go, French. It's in French. Okay.
French.
Not much in the way of special features here. Region A and a whole bunch of trailers, including Mondo titles. That's interesting. 3 hours of short films, no thanks. That's a hard pass for me. Mainly because even if they look good, they're just going to blend to the background and I just won't remember them. I'll just even forget that I saw them. Tony, I'll start with you. What do you think? Grabbing it?
I was, but now I don't know. Like, 3 hours of short films. It's like a horror anthology that's like ABC's of Death or something. It's like, there's so many of them that are bad and to me, and not as many good. So that's what I get afraid of with this kind of stuff.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And even the ones that are good, you may not even remember in a week. Like, wait, what was that one? Where did I even see that?
Yep.
That's my problem. I'm just getting old, maybe. BC, what do you think? 3 hours of short films.
Yeah, a hard pass for me. Doesn't seem interesting.
Image-wise, it looks cool. I mean, these stills are interestingly shot. But if it was a movie with like that box head guy, that might be interesting. But I don't know, man. And price-wise, it's okay. Not bad. $22.
Oh, that's not a bad price.
No. Oh, here we go. Thank you, Witch Dr. Time. Borovchek. Borovchek. I was just calling him Dr. B. The B guy. Who did The Beast, by the way, if you guys know The Beast, the Bigfoot sexing movie. That was interesting. Let me check in with the chat, see what people are saying. We won't watch the trailer for this one because I think it's going to be kind of inappropriate, probably. This dude's other movies, Wild Boys and After Blue, were insane. I've heard that. Brian says he's got the Mondo one. Is it good, Brian? Do you recommend it? Sexy Sumo. Was that the kid from Little Nightmares? Yeah. Oh, dude. It does look like Mondo. It does look. I wasn't going to mention because I didn't think anybody would know it. But it does. It really does. But it's not. Planet Mondo says it looks awesome. Is Wild Boys any good? I didn't see it.
I don't know.
Does anybody in the chat can chime in? Is Wild Boys any good, let us know. All right, moving that, going back to this thing. You know what? Let me turn on the music because I like the music. The new music feature is awesome. I like it. It feels. But I'm going to lower it. So it's just kind of chilling in the background. Okay, guys, here we go. Back to this. Next up, another one that I was interested in at first, but then it's essentially Apocalypse After. And I will I'll explain as we go into it. This is Final Flesh. This is the AGFA release. Also, with I guess a new label, Drag City. I don't. This is the first time I've seen them here, so I guess they're new. What's the standard look like? It doesn't even show it. Okay. So Limited is still in stock. Over 2,000 units for this slipcover, like a drippy eyeball, and then this drawing of like a, I don't even know what it is.
Is it an apple?
It's an apple peeing out its butt or pooping. I'm not sure. Not really sure. Do you know what that is, BC? Could you describe it to us?
No, I'm saying these like artsy corner label movies are kind of like too weird for me. I don't know.
This is too weird for BC, who wanted a whole movie about a sweaty old man having sex with a rubber doll. Okay, so here's some footage from it. Don't worry if it doesn't make any sense. There's a reason why. And I'll explain when I read the description here. Interesting. It is a shot on video movie.
Tears of Neglected Children.
Tears of Neglected Children, yes. Okay, here's the description. Hold on to your butts. You're not going to believe what this movie is. Final Flesh is unlike anything you've ever seen on Earth or other places. Other places, because we do watch movies from other places. In the early 2000s, Vernon Chatham, the co-founder and co-creator of Wondershowzen, Xavier Renegade Angel, and a producer on South Park, wrote a four-part screenplay about a family who lives adjacent to the ground zero of a thermonuclear disaster. Instead of sharing the finished script with Hollywood, Chapman sent each part to four different companies that specialize in custom adult fetish videos. And Final Flesh was born. Like the custom song poem craze of the 1970s, this metaphysical brain stabber is an outsider miracle of biblical proportions. Filled with nudity, that's a plus, brilliant side gags, rubber monster masks, inventive toilet humor, and no sex. This is a surrealist spectacle of the highest order. Does that make it any clearer to you, BC?
No, it's like it sounds like someone would be describing the Jodorowsky film.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I like Santa Sangre quite a bit, and El Topo is pretty good too, but this, I don't know, the way to describe it is like I get a headache watching it.
I think you would. Tony, what do you think? Does this sound interesting to you?
I never saw Wondershowzen, but I've seen a little bit of the Xavier Renegade Angel. That kind of like piques my interest. So it kind of sounds like something I would like. I like weird shit like that. So yeah, kind of interested.
Let me see if I can get us a trailer for this thing. There's tons of nudity, so maybe not. You know what? I'm not even gonna risk it just in case. So we won't show a trailer for that. Region free, so you can watch it worldwide. Preserved from the original Video Master. Video introduction by Greg Turkington. Music video. Looks like a couple of music videos. New alternate score and some commercials and outtakes. This is essentially like After Apocalypse. It's one story, but it sort of feels like it's short films from what I understand. Not into it. But again, something, and I think we can all agree, that we would 100% have taken a jump on at a video store. Rent it for $2? Sure.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And if anybody knows if this is streaming anywhere, I definitely want to watch it, but I certainly don't think I want to own it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I don't want to own this. Final Flesh. That is the AGFA release for this month. Let me check in with everybody here. What does the chat say? Planet Mono says this is 100% gonna be trash. Okay. J Gem says apple juice is a good way to describe whatever that thing is leaking on the back of the thing there. Joe Jack says Wonder Shows it was an amazing bizarre TV show on MTV. It was so funny. This doesn't look good though. Because it's not in the hands of those people, you know. It was the other people made it, so it's strange. Midlife says filled with nudity, so can't be all bad. True,
right?
But then again, I don't want to spend, you know, what is it? I would get it for $20, I guess. I don't spend $20 when I can just get nudity for free at the drop of a Google.
Yeah,
as my grandma would say.
Well, Ballad of Blood, that girl has an amazing body. She's naked most of the time. That doesn't even make it worth watching the movie. So,
good point.
Oh, Battle of Blood. Is that who directed that?
Leonardo.
Yeah, that's the one that I heard was super crappy.
Super crappy, but God. Tony's right. That man, nonstop nudity, and the girl in that has a fantastic pair. And you see it like literally every 5 minutes. You're like, damn, lady, put on a shirt already.
Yeah.
I can only masturbate so much, you know?
I'm drained. Like that apple.
But the movie's so bad. The acting is so bad that it's just, I couldn't finish it. And I finished everything. I could not sit through it.
Wow.
I did finish it.
Oh,
and
God.
I immediately put it on eBay.
Yeah, good for you. It's by still on there. Did it sell?
Yeah, it sold.
Oh,
some sucker bought it. They probably didn't see it.
Yeah, exactly. Well, yeah, there you go. Let's take a hold of damn.
I'm gonna, that's okay. I'm gonna have to drop out now.
Okay, brother.
Some lemon tea. Just, my throat is bothering me.
Not a problem, my friend. You take care. Thanks for hanging in there, and I hope you feel better. Okay, buddy.
All right. Thank you. Bye, bye.
Take care, dude.
UBC.
Yeah, he's a little under the weather today, so it's just gonna be you and me, dude.
Alrighty.
A Jodorowsky with no budget. It's spectacular. You've seen it, Justin? Okay. Oh, here we go. So Justin says it's not short films. It's all one continuous story. You can find it online. Okay. I'll look for it online. Thank you for that. I definitely will be doing that. Let's see. The description sounds like it would give people masturbation blue balls. No sex, boo. Absolutely, sir. I'm pretty selective when it comes to AGFA releases, and this one didn't really say buy me. No, it didn't. It said the opposite to me. Let's see. It does come with a barf orange slip. Yeah, that is a... you'll definitely be able to find it on your shelf. Bikini Mafia, what's up? I bought over half the partner label. So excited. Oh, let me know what you picked up, man. What's y'all's favorite partner labels? Yeah, drop that in the chat, guys. What is your all favorite partner labels? Mine would be AGFA, just because I like those kind of movies, except Final Flesh, because it's a modern movie. I like the Something Weird titles myself. Tony, what's your favorite partner label?
I've only had one movie that I watched with Dark Star, so I like that.
Oh, okay.
Shit. I know they're not. I don't know. I like Saturn's Core and I like Culture Shock. I know they're like not all great, but like I enjoy them. But yeah, I don't really know. I don't have like a ton of sporadic ones. Oh, Gunpowder and Sky Tragedy Girls was really good. So they're making me want to try other titles from them. So
nice, very cool. Mike Ricky angling to get the comment of the stream. Ballad of Blood is my favorite movie of all time. I have the poster tattooed on my back.
Yeah.
That's I can't wait. Send pictures. Actually, no, don't. do not do that. All right. Moving on to Lesbians. This I believe is a documentary, but I'll double check. This is still in stock. Oh, slipcovers flying out the window here.
Wow.
Yeah, Canadian International Pictures. I've not been interested in anything they've put out, but you know, you win me over with certain subject matters. So let's see what this is all about. Get it? Because it's Canadian.
I get it.
See, that's pretty good. I have to
it's
keep
nice.
Oh, no, nice. Okay. In the 1950s, a wave of lesbian pulp literature emerged, exploring a then taboo subject in vivid, sensationalistic detail. While these writers often took a critical, moralistic view of gay life, they provided a jumping-off point for women still discovering their suppressed sexual desires. Oh, okay, so it's a documentary on lesbian pulp novels? That's very interesting. But with society unwilling to grant them a place in public life, they channeled their passion for these novels into a vibrant underground culture full of distinctive codes, roles, and rituals. Mirroring the shadowy traditions of noir fiction, they also faced violent opposition from police and other protectors of the status quo, resulting in a dangerous but ultimately liberating path to sexual awakening. Mixing lively testimonials from unforgettable women at the forefront of mid-century lesbian bar culture with scripted segments that take the Hollywood melodrama in provocative and sexually explicit new directions, Forbidden Love, the unashamed stories of lesbian lives, is an eye-opening cultural history. Feels like something's missing there. And one of the most memorable Canadian films of the 90s. With a soundtrack of late 50s and early 60s hits featuring all those singers, this is a stirring, funny, and ultimately moving portrait of rebellion flourishing in the face of repression. 1992, 85 minutes. How do you feel about this one, Tom? Yeah.
I had it in my cart, and then I took it out.
Okay.
Yeah, I added most of them just in case, you know, and then I was looking at the pictures and here and there. I was like, it's not really my thing.
Right. JJ says, I had Forbidden Love on VHS back when. Dry as Crackers documentary. Oh, no, that sucks.
Oh, man.
That sucks. Okay.
Like those old documentaries, like with the whole, weed and like all that kind of stuff, like from back in, that doesn't really interest me.
Yeah.
You know, I never really cared.
And GK fan might pick it up. Okay. Bullet Blank says, love the slip for it, but the price tag, even discounted, feels outrageous on this one. I actually even looked at the price. Let me look at that real quick. $30. Wow. Oh, yeah. For a document, for an 80-minute documentary, that is pretty. Man, these partner labels pricing has gone insane.
Yeah.
22, maybe 23 with discount, I think. All right. Special features include audio commentary featuring the directors, audio commentary featuring six members of the crew. It looks like a short film called The Ann Banyan Chronicles, and a Q&A with the cast and crew, EPK interviews with the director, an afterword, 19 minutes, and then a booklet with a couple of essays provided there by various folk. This is a really niche title. I think this is for a niche audience, 100%. I would like to watch it, honestly. I think it sounds very fascinating, but I don't need to buy it. So if anybody knows if this is available, you know what? Let's go looking. Let's do some investigating, friends. This is what we do here. Forbidden Love, right?
Yep.
By the way, have you seen RRR yet?
No.
Oh, man. I'm only halfway through. That shit is nuts.
What is RRR?
Oh, it's this. It's the most successful Indian movie. Is it here? Is it in this one? It's the most successful Indian movie of all time. No, that's not it. It's not on IMDb. Maybe I'm looking for the wrong title. That's Forbidden Love.
Forbidden Love, yeah.
It's the most successful foreign language movie of all time. It's now on Netflix, and it's the fucking craziest Indian movie ever made. You need to watch it. It's nuts, dude. The action scenes in that, and there's not a lot of dancing either, so.
Okay, good.
This is an idiot. I can't find it. All right. If anybody knows if it's streaming anywhere, let me know. John, what is up? How you doing, dude? Blake says it's a single disc 80-minute documentary. I can't bring myself to pay more than $20. I agree. Jeffrey says Doris Wishman set is probably my fave partner release after Death. Dad, Jeffrey, we're on the same page there, my brother. Deathlock is awesome. Was it? I thought it was Deadlock. I think it's Deadlock. That was great. And the Doris Wishman set, I haven't gotten mine yet, but I love Doris. Anyway, yeah.
Maybe tomorrow.
Hey, yeah. Hopefully you'll grab it. This one I won't dwell on because it's sold out anyway and there's boobies. So just because YouTube is YouTube. Night Ripper Culture Shock is back with another release that may or may not be good. And, you know, I guess with all of these, most times they're all blind buys. I did buy Death Collector when it was still in stock, so I'm hoping that's good. What the hell is this called again? I already forgot the title. Night Ripper?
Night Ripper.
Well, that's good. All right. It looks like another super lo-fi shot on video thing, which I dig. But pacing has been an issue with a lot of these, and I think that's what would kill me for something like this.
Mm-hmm.
Saw the trailer on Netflix, didn't move me, but keep hearing rave about it. About RRR? Oh, you have to experience it. It's like 3 hours fucking long, but man, it's wild. It's some crazy shit. Like goofy crazy shit, but it's a lot of fun. Fett, what's up? Heading home, but wanted to say hi. Yeah, hopefully you can jump in this the chat here when you're ready. Mob Cold, what's up? Can't really stay. Got a ton of family stuff going on. Wanted to say hi. Well, I hope you're doing well, my buddy. Thanks for popping in. Leave a thumbs up before you take off. Anything with Ripper in the title, I'm sold on. I know. You're easy that way, my friend. You pretty much get anything Ripper. I know.
I get that. I'll watch everything Massacre.
Oh, okay.
Like anything that says Massacre, I'll buy it. It could be terrible. Right. Shannon makes funny about that. She goes, "Oh yeah, Massacre's in the title. You'll watch it." It's like, yeah, damn right I will. Wood Chipper Massacre.
Good to know. that should have been the name of your channel, Massacre Man or something. I don't know.
Tony of the Massacre.
Tony of the Massacre. There you go. Death Collector is their best release. Could have been a standard Vincent title or VSA. Really? Oh, now I'm very excited for that.
That's one I didn't watch yet. I was like not in the mood for it.
Mm-hmm. Planet Mondo says these shot on video movies for $25-$30 are brutal. I get it. Yeah. I absolutely agree. Very excited with commentary with my fave podcast, Movie Melt. Oh, nice. We'll look into that.
Look at it this way, though. You're paying $47 for Video Violence 1 and 2 on Blu-ray when I sold the big box of just Video Violence for over $100.
Oh, wow.
So it sucks, but, you know, if you want to get them on Blu-ray, it's way cheaper than trying to find the VHS.
Yeah, absolutely. You want to read this for us, Tony?
Sure. Fiend disembowels fourth young woman, reports the newspaper. The Ripper is stalking the city, and it's all anyone can talk about. Models all over town are ending up on the wrong side of the razor-sharp blade. Police are baffled by the surgical precision of the corpse mutilation, and their only lead is David, a local photographer who knew a couple of the murdered women. As the beautiful bodies pile up, David's world turns upside down, and the streets run red with blood. Sounds like a jolly...
Yeah, I mean, that sounds like Video Murders. That almost sounds... I haven't watched it, but just from reading the description, it sounds like the exact same thing.
Video Murders.
Video Murders sucks?
First off, it's Video Murder. He murders one person.
Oh.
He tries to murder others, but it's bad.
Okay.
It's a bad one.
Ouch. Okay. Region Free Zone. I didn't get it, so I'm sad for anybody who got it and is not going to enjoy it. The director, the actor, and the actress provide interviews. You get a full-length commentary by Movie Melt, the podcast, extended gore shots, behind-the-scenes still gallery, and then some Culture Shock trailers. Yeah, seems like more of the same. And honestly, if you like what they're putting out, then you're going to dig this. You know, you're not going to... why is this not getting littler? There we go. You're going to dig this. So I would suggest collecting it if you are into what they've put out so far. Or you could wait. This will most likely last till Black Friday. 3,000 units? Oh, yeah. It'll wait till Black Friday. If you don't... Or say use the $10 coupon on that. You can absolutely do that.
Mm-hmm.
But I would suggest it for something else. When we get to it, I'll tell you what it is. Subculture is back, dude. I'm so excited. Subculture is fucking back. They released my favorite thing. Well, yeah, I guess it would be my favorite thing. I said Adoration for the longest time, but the first partner label thing I ever bought. Well, technically it was Agfa, but of the new partner label explosion was Deadlock, and I love that to pieces. Such a good movie. And that was Subculture. They haven't released anything until today. Out of Order, it is a German film, if I'm not mistaken. This is Rene Soundtjik. There's her name. Soundtjik. She is Eve of Destruction. That's how she's probably most famously known. She went up against Gregory Hines in that one. And she's also in Grave Secrets, which is the most obscure VSA title, in my opinion, because it's kind of a horror movie, but it's so slow and nothing really develops. But anyway, we're not reviewing that. We're talking about, is that screaming on your end?
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't know if you could hear that or
no, not. No, it's all good. It's all good. I don't know anything about it, but I hear it's very good. I think it's sort of a disaster survival movie with people stuck in an elevator. And it's a 4K that's cheaper than the video violence. So I'm gonna get it. Coldflick says video murdered my brain cells while watching it.
Right.
And he's pretty, you know, he's pretty kind to most movies. I did watch a review about that on that, Leon. I was like, damn, I'm glad they got it. If only it had Ripper in the title, man.
And then the guy, like the people in it are so bad, like annoying too. Like the main killer, I hate him. I can't like the actor, or not the actor, the character, and then the policeman. It's just like it's annoying. It's like really annoying. Oh by the way, I don't know if you mentioned this earlier before I wasn't on, but for this, if you're a subscriber down there, it says like sub 50.
Oh yeah.
But for the video violence, there's a different code.
Yes. So if
you're gonna order,
mm-hmm.
put video violence alone and put your code in, and then go back and get the rest of them and put your code in.
That is a good point. Yeah, they changed the codes on us. I wanted to highlight a comment from Griff here. Buyer beware with Out of Order. I have seen clips on YouTube. This feels like Dark Tower to me.
Oh no.
All right, I'm not gonna blind buy this one. I'm gonna. If anyone knows a way to seek this out, I will. I'm definitely gonna TBYB this one.
How many are live over 1,000?
Oh yeah, there's plenty. I think it's got 3,000 units. Yeah, it'll last.
Oh okay.
Girl from Hell was the peak of Culture Shock's releases for me. Justin, I'm with you, man. I'm with you, and that was like the first one they really did with Vinegar Syndrome. I'm with you. That was the best of the best. If you thought Frankie and his pals was fun, though, you might like Creep Tales. I didn't think Frankie and his pals was fun. As a matter of fact, you can go back and watch my review on that. Not a lot of people know what Frankie and his pals is if they haven't been paying attention to Severn for a while, because they were true to their word. That's a one and done. It will disappear. It has never been reprinted. And only those who have suffered through it know it. Did you get Frankie and his pals, Tony?
No, I never even heard of that.
Okay, good. It was an Intervision title that Severn released like 2 years ago. I guess just about 2 years ago, because that's when I started the channel. One of the first things I reviewed. And gosh damn it, was it fucking awful. And wow. I mean, that's honestly where I started thinking, you know what? I think they're lying to us. I don't think they're putting out good movies on purpose. I think they're just whatever they can find. Like maybe it's a prank. it's like this is their version of Jackass. Oh, you think they'll buy this? Yeah, sure. Put boobs on the cover.
And those fucks will buy anything.
Call it the Ripper Massacre and put a boob on the cover.
Well, yeah.
Okay, on Friday evening, four people board the elevator in an office building. After it gets stuck, they soon realize that their cries for help go unheeded. Desperate, they decide to free themselves on their own and climb out through a hatch. When their lives are in great danger, a fight breaks out and the situation escalates completely. With every additional minute in this claustrophobic narrowness, the veil of superficiality lifts and reveals a glimpse into the human abyss that is much deeper than the elevator shaft beneath their feet. I mean, that sounds very interesting. It's a 90-minute movie with people trying to get out of an elevator shaft. That sounds like that could be really, really good, Tony.
Yeah. I mean, being stuck in an elevator is terrifying, I think. So.
Yeah.
You know, and yeah. I mean, I'll be honest. I bought it.
Oh, there you go. Okay. Yeah. Justin
I'm done shopping right now. I just ordered what I wanted.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Justin says he watched the trailer and it looked way better than Dark Tower. You know, is there doesn't look like there's an official trailer, but maybe I'll find one on YouTube. It's a regular one. Why don't you give us a rundown on the special features there while I look for a trailer?
We got a region free 4K UHD Blu-ray interview with actor Hans Janicki, 28 minutes. Interview DP Jock Stein, 19 minutes. Alternate version with SD inserts, isolated music track, English opening and end credits silent, opening and end credits textless silent, German theatrical trailer, gallery, and English subtitles.
I can't find it. I can't find it on YouTube. I'm putting it out of order. I know it has a German name, but I'm blanking on the moment. Somebody can put it in the chat. I'll grab it from there.
The but German name is Rick 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 Rick.
Oh my God. Oh wow. Wow, you have such a way with language.
Thank you.
3,000 units. I'm gonna TBYB this one, but it this is probably one I'll circle back on eventually, I think. Let's see. Oh, that's what it is. Abwarts. Abwarts 1984 trailer on YouTube.
1984. It's a good year.
It is.
It's a good year for movies.
Abwarts. Is this Abwarts. It?
It sounds like my 2-year-old when he was first trying to say apples. He called it Abbots. Abbots.
Oh yeah, I found it. I love how kids talk when they're little, man. There's just something adorable about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, funny how like one day you're like trying to get them to talk, and then now they don't shut up.
Oh my God! Yeah. Like fine, you can talk, great.
Yeah. Now shut the fuck up.
Go to bed. Oh man.
Oh, kids, they're great.
They're the best. They are the best. Parents, I mean, parents, we mess around, but absolutely, at a split second, would die for our children.
Absolutely. You know,
that's the thing about a parent. Like, it was like, oh my God, it's so tough being a parent. But the minute anything scary happens, you know, you're in there and you'll do anything.
Yeah.
To make sure that they survive.
That's like the one thing I worry about all the time is keeping them safe.
Mm-hmm.
I've never been on edge so much in my life.
It's the scariest thing ever, man, being a parent. Yeah. All right. Abwarts. Or
Abwarts.
Also known as Out of Order.
Keine mehr im Haus ist, ja.
It's in German.
Mach dich lieber bemerkbar.
When are you going to cut the ponytail?
Weiter nichts.
No one likes it. Yeah, bang it against the wall. We'll cut it off.
He's a Padawan learner from
Jedi. Yeah.
Abwarts on the Cronenberg flick.
Abwarts.
Drei Männer und eine Frau, die sich nicht mehr unter Kontrolle haben. Eingesperrt auf engstem Raum.
I love the German language.
Zwischen dem 27. Stockwerk und dem Abgrund.
Das schafft er nicht.
Alright.
Würdest du es?
Man hat da oben keinen Halt.
Was soll er denn da? Er
hat mich genervt.
Oh, this is going to be a great conversation when we can understand what they say.
Schmeiß das Ding weg oder ich bring dich um, du. Ich bring dich um.
Mm-hmm.
Ich bring dich um.
Somebody always opens the hatch in the top and climbs up. That's never the person that lives.
Abwärts.
It's never.
Mm-mm.
Abwärts.
Abwärts.
Jetzt bist du dran.
Liebe, Hass, Eifersucht.
I knew that
yeah,
was
but they're all like sweating, bro.
Ich kann nicht mehr.
Was in dieser Nacht geschieht, erleben Sie in
My Records.
Abwärts.
Den Jungen umgebracht.
Yeah, we know Gotts George is in it.
Ich hab gehört, wie sie gesagt haben, ich bring dich um.
Wolf Gang's killing it.
Das hab ich auch gehört.
Renee sucked dick. Oh, look at that. Come on, trailer, you're showing too much.
Ich glaube, ich bin verrückt.
We can use the money to escape.
You just got to make sure you watch enough movies before you watch this that you forget the trailer.
Right, yeah, exactly. Well, it'll be at least a month before anyone gets it.
That's true, yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, ow.
Oh.
Abwärts. Ab Mai. Überall im
I agree. Deadlock was a masterpiece. But I've learned that just because the label releases one good movie doesn't mean they're all good.
True.
Case in point, Culture Shock, Vinegar Syndrome, Agfa. I mean, everybody.
Everybody, yeah.
Okay, out of order. That's a maybe for me. But you already grabbed it. So
yeah, I grabbed one.
Hopefully, if you get a chance to watch it before I get a chance to watch it, you'll fill us in on whether it's good or not.
I will.
Okay. Polystyrene, I am a cliche. I'm pretty sure it's not for me, but I will I'll flip through it here. I think it's about a band. I might be mistaken. I think it's a documentary. Maybe not. Oh, this is a great shot. It's about a girl being sad in different places. Okay. This is a, did you grab this? It's 1,000 units only.
No, I didn't.
Look at this. You better jump on that, man.
Nah, it didn't interest me.
It didn't interest you. I get you. Razor says, it kind of reminds me of Belko Experiment. The Abwarts. Yeah, I can see that. Belko wasn't that great either.
I like Belko.
It was okay. I don't know. Joe
Jackson. I like those kind of movies, like people going crazy.
Yeah. You've seen The Sadness, though, right? That's amazing.
I haven't watched it yet. I know what you're talking about, though. I know you said the other day, but yeah, man. The trailer keeps coming up for me now, so I have to watch it.
If you like crazy people going crazy movies, that is the ultimate. You will love it. Joe Jack says he's down for crazy German movies. This could be pretty good. It could be really great. Macabre, what's up? Good to have you here. What's on the menu tonight? Let me know. Okay, Polystyrene was the first woman of color in... Of color? That was a white girl. I don't know. It wasn't?
No.
Are you serious?
Well, they showed a couple pictures of a white girl, but...
Oh, okay. All right, so I didn't go crazy. First woman of color in the UK to front a successful rock band and a key influence on the Riot Girl and Afropunk movements. I was not aware of those movements. But Polly didn't just leave behind a cultural footprint. She was survived by a daughter, Celeste, who became the steward of her mother's legacy and demons, which plagued Polly's life and scarred the pair's relationship. With narration by Ruth Negga, and I'm pretty sure that's how she pronounces it, this film follows Celeste's journey to better understand Polly as an icon and mother. So it's looks like it's a documentary on this sort of punk icon. Are you familiar with her music at all? I've not heard of her work before.
Doesn't sound familiar. It definitely sounds like something though that I would want to just watch on like something. I don't want to own it.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Q&A, select scene commentary, and a booklet with a couple of one essay by Dana Reynous, and then intros by the directors. Interesting. Anybody in the chat a punk fan? It seems like this would be right up their alley. And it seems like Utopia is sort of focusing. I might be mistaken. I have to look at the rest of their output. But I think they're the label that put out all those like Green Jelly, right? And all those other kind of like music docs.
No, that's ETR.
ETR. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, ETR and Scream Queen, they put out Scream Queen, and DG put out Heavy Trip. But Utopia, I don't think I have any Utopia. So I couldn't tell you what they put out.
Oh, we'll take a look at that. I only usually watch docs one though, so once though, so I pass. I agree. Same.
Yeah.
I don't rewatch anything. I don't have time to rewatch shit.
It really depends on the documentary. Like I said last time, I watched Pumping Iron so many times that I love it. I used to watch it before the gym too, and then also that Canon one.
Oh yeah.
Love that one. That was fantastic.
Utopia did Bloody Nose. Bloody Nose, Empty Pockets, and Martha, A Picture Story. Two that I passed on. Mm. Interesting. So they do kind of do docs, kind of unique looking docs.
That's cool. They stick to something though, you know?
Yeah. And I mean, I think that's what a label should be, essentially. Like, you can always expect this from, this label.
Yeah.
Griff says, I don't know how crazy it is. You can watch the first 40 minutes or so on YouTube. Just a bunch of talking. Oh, wow. Yeah, and trailers are deceptive, unfortunately.
Yeah. You know, that makes me excited, though, now, because the Utopia, not Utopia, Terrorvision. Now, like, the two hits or ones they have that I have is WNUF and then Killing Spree.
Mm-hmm.
And now Video Violence. I'm thinking we're probably going to get the Camp Motion Pictures line.
You know, it's possible, man. It's possible. I mean, the Polonia Brothers box set would be amazing.
Oh my god, that thing would be the whole shelf.
Yeah, the whole shelf. You'd have to do the Cardona thing with it. That would be kind of fun, but again, you know, not great movies, but geez, how fun would they be to have those. Razor says King of Kong and Best Worst Movie are both rewatchable docs for me. Oh, nice.
Oh, King of Kong, yeah, that's good.
Yeah,
that's a good one.
Utopia did Shiva Baby. That was great. That was a good movie. I really love that lead actress. She was very, very good. She's in a new horror movie, and it looks awful. Bodies, Bodies, Bodies.
Like a
slasher one.
Yeah.
I saw
Pete Davidson's in that, right?
Yeah, I saw a trailer last night, and it looks obnoxious as hell. but it could be obnoxious in a good way. Like, is satirically dumb. It could work for it, but I don't know.
We'll probably end up watching because Shana likes Pete Davidson. I don't get it.
Why do girls like him? He's so
I weird. Don't know. Why was he even on Saturday Night Live?
this dude hooked up with like some of the hottest women ever, and he looks like a junkie.
Yeah. And he said, even he said, like, I don't know why I'm on this show. I don't know. I know he's on now. He quit, but like he's like, I'm the luckiest guy in the world, and I don't even know why.
Yeah, that's. I mean, he's had a tough life. I know he lost his dad during 9/11. So I mean that shit sucks. I lost my parents, so that's awful. Yeah. The dude can get it. So good for him.
Yeah, good for him. I don't know why my wife thinks he's hot, but good for him.
I would ban all Pete Davidson stuff in the house. No Pete Davidson here.
Yeah.
Okay, this is an autobiographical comedy about a boy growing up in the collapsing USSR, his mail-order bride mother, and their escape to Seattle in the 90s. This film is an immigrant's take on the American dream, proving that life is often stranger than fiction. And it seemed like it was an LGBT title because I saw in some of the pictures there. Interesting.
Yeah.
I don't know. $7.99 left of this limited edition slipcover. Does not jump out to me as something that I need to have. But if people are into it, people are into it. Blu-ray, Region A, director's commentary. It looks like these aren't even unfinished. There's not a lot of details here. Behind the scenes featurette, introduction by the actors, an actor's interview, deleted scenes and outtakes, and then a mini documentary called Little Potato. And then two short films, and then season one of some kind of web series, I guess the director made. I don't know. Interesting. Should we do a trailer for Potato Dreams? I don't know. I don't know how many people are interested in that.
I picked it up because of Dark Star.
Ah, okay.
I thought, you know, with the last matinee, I really enjoyed that, so I thought I'd take a chance.
That's cool. I might be making a movie. I'm probably speaking out of turn. It may not happen, but I'll mention it just for fun for those of you who are hanging out and paying attention. I might be making a movie with the guy who did Last Matinee.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. He likes the script I wrote, and we're actually gonna have a meeting and see what happens. But you know, Hollywood things can fall through the wayside and may not happen, but
Last Matinee had like one of the coolest kills in it that I've seen in a while. And you probably know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, no, it's a good movie. It's a very, very good movie.
Yeah.
American movie is very rewatchable. I agree with that. That is a very good one. And also Zombie Girl. That was a very good documentary. Let's see. Hoke says, I saw Potato Dreams of America a few months ago. It was a solid coming-of-age film. Okay. There you go. But who's the coming-of-age people? It's not Dark Star.
Oh, that's...
Altered Innocence.
Yeah, Altered Innocence.
That would have been perfect for them.
Mm-hmm.
Timothy says, Pete Davidson must give good head. I don't know. Maybe.
Even Miley Cyrus wanted him.
Yeah, oh, wow.
Forget it.
824 is putting out amazing movies. I don't know about Bodies, 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 though. Seems like a comedy. Yeah, it seems a little too goofy for what they put out. Mike Riggy says, Pete Davidson has a huge wee-wee. I've seen it with my own eyes.
Does he really, though?
I believe Mike.
I don't know. This is the same guy who has a tattoo of Video Murders. Or not what Video Murders. What is it on his back?
Ballad and Blood.
Yeah.
I believe him. He would not lie to me. I believe him.
Yeah.
John says, hey, MC, hello to you, John. I hope you're well. Hope your family's well, dude.
He's got a huge wiener and lots of weed.
Lots of weed, yeah. I mean, the dude looks like he's always high. I think he is, yeah. You're right, Leon. I'm glad you liked Last Matinee.
Yeah.
Moving on. We're almost at the end. Red Lips.
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of nips, I was very excited for this, but then I remember
saw it with Saturn's car.
It's Saturn's core, man. And Red Lips is one of those movies that's it's kind of like I wouldn't say like a Moby Dick for S Channel Video movies, but it's one of those like white whale titles where like, oh, have you seen Red Lips?
Mm-hmm.
It's always eluded me. And then there was a chance that I had a chance to see it at some point. But then I found out it was directed by Donald Farmer, and I was like, I'm not a giant Donald Farmer fan. I do appreciate his cinema, but I passed. But it was like I don't know if it was bootleg or not, but it was on VHS, and it was like $30. I'm like, nah.
Yeah.
I don't think so. But the main reason I would get it.
Oh, yeah.
Is beautiful woman right here. I mean, I think every guy has a crush on Michelle Bauer.
If you don't, it's because you don't know about her.
Yeah, but look at how atrocious this looks. This is the best scans they could pull for these pictures from the remastered Blu-ray of Red Lips. I mean, this just looks like it would hurt. Like, your eyes should not see these, this quality.
Yeah.
And there's no nudity in those pictures. So wait a minute. Is there not nudity in this movie? Because Donald Farmer and his recent stuff has not done nudity. Even though he casts like big booby women, none of his shark stuff has nudity in it. And it was always a fucking bummer.
Hmm.
Can anybody confirm if this has nudity in it?
Well, I mean, Michelle Bauer is always nude, so you never know.
Right?
And Kitten, how do you say her last name? Navidad?
Natividad.
Natividad? She's up probably naked.
I mean, she should
George
be.
George Stover's probably naked.
ha ha ha. Donald Farmer is prolific. He is. He is indeed. This is the best Donald Farmer movie of the ones that I've seen. And there is nudity in it, guys.
Good, good.
Yes. Mondo says, this one looks so bad. I don't blame you, sir. Would you read this for us, Tony?
Desperate for cash, young Caroline agrees to be injected with an experimental serum by an unscrupulous blood bank donor. She soon finds herself transformed to a ravenous vampire stalking the streets of New York City with an unquenchable lust for blood. After killing her doctor and a random string of unfortunate strangers, Carolyn crosses paths with Lisa, an innocent woman stranded in a city after a breakup with her former girlfriend. The two broke up, and star-crossed lovers navigate through the city's desolate clubs and hotels, fueled only by their sexual lust and symbolic need for companionship. When Lisa finally learns of Caroline's murderous proclivities, I never heard that word before in my life, she becomes a willing participant in her vampiric crimes until an unfortunate encounter with an indigenous pimp leads to tragedy. Written and directed by shot on video legend Donald Farmer, Red Lips marked the on-screen confluence of two iconic screen queens, legendary 80s siren Michelle Bauer and the awe-inspiring 90s enigma Getty Chasen. Grotica, that's great. With an astonishing supporting cast of cult movie luminaries, including Kitten, how'd you say it again? Natividad. George Stover, Danny Fendley, Larissa McCombs, Christine Cavalier, and Mandy Lee, Red Lips quickly gained a reputation as a notorious sex and gore-filled underground classic that is notable as one of the springboards for the shot-on-video lesbian vampire movie explosion, which dominated video shelves and convention tables throughout the 90s and beyond. Either it's amazing or they're trying to sell you.
Oh, they're trying to sell me, but they got me with the late Larissa McComas. Rest in peace, Larissa. She is she's a beautiful woman, an excellent body, and whenever she's in anything, it makes me very happy. So to see her in a movie with Michelle Bauer, I mean, I'd be stupid not to pick it up. whatever. If it sucks, I'll trick BC into buying it. Or actually, my buddy Zach, who collects Saturn's Core, he might buy it off me if I don't like it.
When I said Grotica, that's the one I didn't see. I was thinking Gorgasm. There's Gorgasm and Gore Whore.
Gore Whore. I've seen those. Vincent, yeah. It looks like garbage. The quality of this for a little backyard wrestling. Yeah.
It's definitely going to be an acquired taste.
Sure.
You know.
Absolutely.
I'm excited for it.
I think they meant it sat on shelves and didn't get rented. I'm honest here. It's probably not going to be very good, but I will get it for the potential of nudity. Yes, I'm that easy. Region free Blu-ray, audio commentary with Don Farmer, interview with him, vintage interview with Getty Chasen, who I've never heard of before. I don't know who she is, but apparently everyone knows her. I don't know. Then you get a video essay by Carolyn Kopko on Distortion is a Woman, The Blood Transgressions of Red Lips. Ooh, sounds like a college essay all about Red Lips. damn, you know what? It's crazy enough and to make it work. I think it might be worth it. I kind of wish with these movies that they would include a free movie on there. Because I know there's a part two for Red Lips. So it would have been nice to have part two. I mean, I hope they don't release part two on a separate thing. I don't know. Maybe they will. But is it $20 or so? $19? Yeah, I'll take a throw on it. I think I'll grab it.
Where is Michelle Bauer nowadays? Like, I know she's around, but like, I would like to see an interview with her.
Yeah, I mean, she's still active. Maybe, I mean, as far as I know, she's still acting too.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Maybe it'll come. Like, maybe it's like a more to come kind
of thing. I think most of them are more to come. SOV, you either love or hate, or you're okay with it. Some people can just be, yeah, I'm okay with some and I hate others.
I'm a big fan of shot on video.
Yeah.
I like it.
My first movie was shot on video. I'll show you guys one day.
It makes me feel like that I could do it, you know?
Nowadays, it's so easy to make a movie.
You just have your phone.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that crazy?
Absolutely.
Wow.
But should you is the question.
Some
just
people
should. Just because you can doesn't mean you should, you know?
That's right.
Griff says, that slipcover looks nice, though. Have to admit. Yeah, I think I'm going to grab it.
The only thing with these, with that company, though, with the, who was it? Core? Yeah, Saturn's Core, Culture Shock. I don't know why they can't clean it up more. It's like I'm buying a Blu-ray, but it's not Blu-ray. Like, that's the only thing that bothers me.
Yeah, they look really bad.
Maybe they think it'll take it away, but just put it on DVD. I don't know.
Yeah, that's a good point. Recently, I saw Hey, Stop Stabbing Me. I mean, that was sort of a more recent movie than these.
Mm-hmm.
But that looked really fucking nice. Like, it looked clean. It didn't have the fifth generation look of these titles. Maybe they just had better elements. Obviously, it's a newer movie. Newish, I think 2000 was when they made it. So that might be it. It might just be that's just the quality of the video. There's nothing you can do. And that's why you'll never see SOV on 4K.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Nor should you, really.
Nor should you. Yeah. What is the appeal of these SOV releases? I don't get it. I think it's more nostalgia. Again, you know, Vinegar Syndrome, most of the audience... the film fans here, we love trash cinema. We love underground weird shit. And SOV is a part of that. SOV is a big part of that. But Vinegar Syndrome does not release video titles. So luckily we've got companies like this, like Agfa and... what the hell is the company? I'm blanking on the name of it now.
There's like 50 of them.
What the fuck was it? Saturn's Core. Okay. Companies like them, that they will focus on the SOV stuff that gets, you know, people love, but it's a very, very dedicated niche. It's not everybody who walks away with it going, oh yeah, I love it.
Mm-hmm. It might not be a good movie, but there's a certain charm to it.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. JJ says it's still on DVD though, if you guys just want to grab the DVD. Let's see. Griff says, I think some of them are just really bad off and they do the best they can to clean them up. Yep.
I get that. I mean, you do what you can.
Do what
you can. But I just, it's like I'm watching The Block, you know, like it's like I'm putting the VHS in. Whatever.
Essentially. A lot of the SOB stuff was shot on tape, then edited on tape, and then mastered on tape. So even a master isn't first generation. Absolutely true. I used to edit a VCR to VCR. Good times. Good memories.
I never did that kind of stuff.
Oh, man. Good times. So it's a lot of work. You really want to have to edit your movie if that's how you need to do it. Only 1,000 units for this slipcover for the film Superior. 773 left. I'm not familiar with this movie. I don't think it's American. She reminds me of somebody.
I think she looks like Angelina Jolie there.
Yeah, a little bit.
I think she's hot, though.
That's a dude. No, I don't know.
I don't care.
is this a thrill? I don't know. It looks like is this almost looks like they're Siamese twins by this artwork. But I, you know, let's not believe the artwork. Let's see. When Marion is on the run, she goes to the only place she knows is safe, her childhood home. She is greeted by her estranged sister, Vivian, a stay-at-home housewife struggling to conceive and on the verge of a failing marriage. Though the two are identical twins, they live opposite lives. Marion's mysterious return disrupts Vivian's small-town routine, and the sisters must learn to reconnect and reconcile. When Marion's haunting past finally catches up to her, their separate worlds collide, catapulting both sisters into grave danger. I'm not sure. It's in English, but it looks like a foreign film. At least the actors look...
2021.
Recent. I don't know. I don't know anything about it. This is probably on Amazon Prime or something if you guys want to try before you buy. Let's do a search. Superior. It looks interesting. Looks like it could be a fun little thriller. Superior 2021. Load this up for us. Oh, this looks pretty close to what actually happens in it. Looks like there is no way to watch it except the blue. Yep, no way to watch it. Then Superior, 773. Did you pick this one up, Tony?
I think I did. I think I did. I have to actually look. I don't remember if I had that or if I took it out.
Gotcha. Justin was intrigued by the trailer, but he had too much in his cart. I get it. I completely understand that.
Yeah, I got it.
Nice. Maybe we'll watch the trailer. Why don't you read to us the special features there while I look for the trailer real quick?
Well, it's a region-free Blu-ray. Commentary with Aaron Vesalopoulos, Alessandra Mesa, Annie Mesa, production designer Allison Pierce, and cinematographer Mia Seal Henry. Short film Valeria. Future of film is a female post-screening Q&A moderated by Karen Coleman. A trailer. 28-page booklet including interviews with director Aaron V and editor Jen Roof, and essays by Aaron V and Lucy Fisher, and English subtitles. A booklet. Which is nice, but I don't care.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's nice.
But it confirms that it's not in English because it kind of you need English subtitles. Yeah. Unless it's like, oh, maybe hard of hearing subtitles. All right, let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Griff says Tony needs an intervention. We'll get to that in a minute. I agree. We have to help him.
Why?
Hello? Vivian?
Oh, it's in English. Okay, good.
Mary, what is this? I haven't heard from you in 6 years, and you just show up without warning? It's hard to explain.
Have you heard from Marion this past week?
I wanted to know if you had any more information about my sister. I'm worried about her. You can't pretend to be me anymore. It's dangerous.
It does look very Lynchian. Huh. It does look very Lynchian. What do you think?
Yeah.
I think I'll probably still wait to TBYB somehow, but it doesn't look terrible. Looks like it could be quite a hoot. All right. Yeah. all right, let's talk about the last thing on here. And it's one that is very interesting and one that I'm going to give a recommendation for, but I don't know if it's for everybody. But it's definitely something worth your time if you are an adventurous cinephile. Let's talk about this box set from Deaf Crocodile, which is a new label that has become a an early favorite of mine, honestly. I really do enjoy what they're doing, and I've liked pretty much everything they put out except that Space cartoon. I didn't grab that. Does that look
good? I didn't grab that either. I had no interest in that.
Yeah, it didn't look good to me. The Time-Bending Mysteries of Sharam Moghri. Now, this guy makes very interesting movies. In the leaked artwork, or, you know, the partner labels only poster that they put up, not really leaked, but, you know, talking about what's coming, someone called out the film Fish and Cat. This guy's from Fish and Cat right here. And so I was able to get my hands on Fish and Cat, and I was able to watch it. I watched it a couple nights ago. And dang it. Where is it? I know there's a still of it. I saw it a second ago. Let's see. Oh, this is from Fish and Cat. And this is from Fish and Cat. This is actually the poster, the original poster. It's this and like the words at the bottom. So, real quick, this filmmaker, I'll be reviewing it for Patreon, so I'm not going to go too much into details on Fish and Cat.
I'm a Patreon.
I know. Thank you, by the way. That's very nice of you, dude. You didn't have to do that, but thank you, sir.
Oh, well, then I won't subscribe next month.
Okay, great. Thanks. good. I can talk about Tony again. Yes. Mondo says, I'm Persian, so I'm excited for this one. Oh, you're gonna have a good time with this one. By the way, man, Persian women are beautiful. I mean, that's just an aside. But God, yeah. Beautiful. Especially Efficient Cat. I think every girl in this is just a knockout. This filmmaker is very interesting to me. I never heard of his stuff before, but after I saw Efficient Cat, I'm like, I want to see more of his work. And guess what Def Crocodile does? They give me a box set. So I could see three other of his films. Okay. I'm gonna give you the elevator pitch for Efficient Cat without giving anything away. Efficient Cat is essentially a slasher in the woods movie. However, it also isn't, and it plays with time and space. The most important thing that you must know about this movie, it was shot in one continuous take. The movie is 2.5 hours long. Let that sink in. This is a 2.5 hour long take. So wow. The camera follows actors through those woods into this big lake area, and then it just wanders picking up different characters. And I'm talking about a choreography unlike anything I've ever seen in my life. In a filmmaking choreography that is jaw-dropping. They'll pick up a character that we finished with that character 10 minutes ago. We pick up with that character. We circle back. We see more of his story. And somehow we leap back to a part that we've already experienced. And so it time travels back and forth, weaving into these characters' lives. And the subplot is that there's a killer on the loose who kills tourists and feeds them to people at his restaurant. But you wouldn't know it if you're not paying attention. As a matter of fact, I think I was going to watch this a second time, but I think I'm just going to grab this box set and watch it with a little nicer version of it. A second viewing would unlock so much more, because now when you get to the end of the movie, like, holy fuck, did I just miss the whole point of this movie? And it's one of those things, like the second viewing, like, oh, shit. I love that. And so I can only recommend one movie because I've only seen this one. I go into detail more on Patreon, but Efficient Cat is unlike anything I've ever seen, and I've seen a lot of shit. This is a 2.5 hour, one take movie with the most epic choreography of all time. But on the surface, it is mostly old men talking in the woods, and it is, a young people talking about flying kites. So it focuses on the mundane stuff, but it's the stuff in the background that is the movie, if that makes any sense. Gosh, it is fucking good. I mean, the more I think about it, the more I'm like, this. I you know what? Get it for this movie. I don't know what the other ones are about, but we'll look at that in a minute. Mob Cult is so.
Yeah, I didn't pick it up, but now I did.
Oh, good.
I thought $50. What the hell? And it's like, oh, there's a box set. Okay. Yeah. Cool.
It is it's in Farsi, yeah. So subtitles are your friend. Well, but Mondo, if you're Persian, then you'll get it.
You know, I watch everything with subtitles anyway. Like, even if it's, I guess I got used to it. Growing up with my kid, it helped him see what the words that he's hearing. And then I get so used to it. And plus, with kids, it's always loud. You have to have subtitles on. So I just got so used to it. Even in my room, I put it on.
Yeah.
And I'll watch with subtitles.
You know, it's funny. Mondo, you're right. It is, does seem like something Criterion would 100% have put out.
Yeah, that sounds like it.
Which is great. And actually, there might be some movie stuff on the Criterion channel. I have to look.
I remember when this was coming out.
Yeah.
And I haven't watched it yet. But I know the trailer looked cool and everything.
It's good. It's a good movie.
And it's the same guy, right?
No, that's a different a different person.
Same label though.
Same label, yeah. But anyway, yeah, man, Efficient Cat, holy fucking balls. What an achievement. Just honestly, it's more of a movie for filmmakers. I think filmmakers will really dig into it, like, oh man, how did you do this? How did you time that? If I don't even know how they hit the boom guy, because you see the boom once, guys, cut. We have to go back. We just lost 2 hours of footage. It boggles the mind how they did that. It's amazing to me.
Is it like kind of like Birdman, like that?
Kind of like Birdman, but you could there's no obvious cuts. The whole thing is one take.
Wow.
Because they don't do any of that, like people coming to the lens and then like, they hit a cut there. They don't do that stuff.
Okay.
Amazing.
That definitely has my interest because I think that's awesome.
I don't know if all his movies are like that, but this one specifically is special because of that.
Their drum playing in the background.
No drum theme this time. Iranian culture is fascinating. I'm down. Yeah, I don't know how culturally, you know, it sticks to the culture of it, but it certainly, goddamn, fishing cat blew me away. Looks like with our discount, what did you buy already? What was the discount?
It was just like $12 and something off.
Oh, good. Good. Yeah. Awesome. So $35, something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
Okay.
It's definitely better than 50. It was a good price. Like, okay, if I would saw that in the store for that much, I'd be like, okay, that's cool.
Definitely better than 50. Yeah. 2000 units limited. It is a spot gloss slip cover. So, it's a slip cover. So it's not a box, but kind of a box. Let's see if we get details on how it's divided. All right. What is time? What is memory? Are we in the past or present or some strange, unknowable hybrid of the two, hunted by arsonists, bloodsuckers, serial killers, and phantom images of our own selves? The films of Iranian director Shahram Mokri, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, straddle the line between genre and art house cinema. Whether Mobius strip-like meditations on classic 1970s American slasher films, Fish and Cat, Mobius strip, that's a good way to put it, political thrillers, Careless Crime, and 1980s new wave sci-fi vampire movies, Invasion, that sounds really fun, or offbeat Jarmusch meets Tarantino indie mysteries, Ashcan, The Holy Ring, and other stories. It's a small wonder that Abbas Kiarostami, in his last film, 24 Frames, left a cryptic message on screen in Persian that simply read, Shahram Mokri. That's interesting. I didn't know that. I guess Kiarostami's a fan. That's fantastic.
Neat.
Guys, this is I think, the hidden gem in the releases this month. I 100% genuinely do mean that. Of course, mileage may vary, and I think probably filmmakers might get a little more out of Fish and Cat, but if you don't watch it on the surface, you're going to get a lot out of that movie. Four disc, a Region A Blu-ray set, so it looks like it's going to be kind of a, you know, Cardona collection type of thing with just the Emery case with like the four discs in there. Nearly 4 hours of Q&A. Wow, interviews with the director and behind the mind of Shahram Mokri. 22 minutes. I'm looking forward to hearing more about this guy. I don't love special features. I mean, I enjoy them, but I don't watch a lot of them. But I do watch director interviews when the directors are interesting people, like Shinya Tsukamoto when he did his introductions for the Solid Metal Nightmares. That was I watched everything with him in it because I was just so curious about his mind. Like, who is this guy? How does he think like this? It's insane to me. So I want to know more about Mokri, and this is the way to do it.
Yeah.
Four fucking movies, man. Great.
You need to watch the special features, the interview for Alien Private Eye.
I don't have it anymore. I gave that to DC.
You might not hate him as much.
No, I'm sure he's a nice guy. all right. So that is the partner labels for June. Let's see. Joe Jack says, I really dig how the partner labels are becoming a big spot for world cinema. I'm with you on that. I think that is pretty amazing, you know, that we're getting something very different from the Vinegar Syndrome stuff with the partner labels. And thank God, because there's a lot of good stuff out there. And again, it's going to be so varied, it's not going to hit everybody the same way. And that's fine. That's how movies work. They're not supposed to work for everybody. Yeah. That's, you know, as much as Hollywood wants a four quadrant movie, you're not going to always make a Morbius. You know, there's only a one-time hit. You know, every once in a while you'll make a Morbius and then that's it. And the rest of the movies are shitty. You know, have you heard about this Morbius going back to theaters thing?
No.
So, well, Morbius is an awful movie. But on Twitter, people have been like pumping it up saying, oh man, Morbius is the best, the greatest movie of all time. And I guess the studio believed them. And now they're releasing it back into theaters for this weekend only because they thought that people would go watch it.
And no one's going to go.
No one's going to go. My favorite meme, you know what? Maybe I don't know if I can find it, but anyway, if I can find it, I'll show it. So I'm not going to ruin it here. But have you even seen the movie?
No. I haven't seen that. I haven't seen the new Doctor Strange. I haven't seen Ghostbusters. I haven't seen much. I kind of wait till it's like Black Friday and I just kind of buy it for $10.
That's kind of what I do as well. I love this meme. I gotta show you this. And we're talking about fucking Morbius, but it cracks me up that what the internet was able to do. It's insane to me. So this was, if you're a Dragon Ball fan, I don't know if you are, Tony, but I think most people would get this reference anyway. Let's fight somewhere empty.
There you go.
And they're fighting at Morbius. That cracked me up so much.
It's sad that's movie bombed because I thought the trailer looked okay.
Oh, man. It's really stupid, though. They do so much stupid stuff with that movie. It's so, so bad. Vincent Afal, is Alien Private Eye bad? Haven't had a chance to watch it yet. You're going to get mixed reviews on that. I did not enjoy it, but I think Tony and my buddy Bullet Blake enjoyed it very much.
I liked it. Bullet loved it. You got different variations of it.
It's okay. It really depends on, I mean, you're the Vin Cinephile, so I'm pretty sure you'll like it.
Mm-hmm.
What's up, Video Man? Hey, any good titles? Absolutely, a whole bunch. It's not a bad, well, not a whole bunch. Maybe two? Three really good ones? At least I'm picking up three. I did go over Video Blinds at the beginning of the video because BC was here and he was sick, and that's his one of his favorite movies, so I wanted to go over it while he was here. And Cam says, the Mokri one looks really dope. Cam, you're going to dig it. It's good stuff. You got a couple of other merch items here. You got some OCN t-shirts, which looks like they're going fast. You know what? Do you think that they just don't have a lot in stock so that it looks like it's selling out fast?
Yeah.
Like maybe they have like 20 of each or something?
Which for a whole internet's more than plenty.
Yeah.
fuck.
OCN 43 left. I don't know what they started with, but a prospect screen print, a holographic, and orange. I'm not sure how many people are going to be buying that, but if you like Prospect and you want a poster, get it here.
Yeah.
I don't know how many people are going to be buying this thing.
I haven't watched this Red Spirit Lake or the We Wait one, but like,
it's
why of all of them are those the prints? You know?
I have no idea, but I didn't think it was very good at all. Actually, no, I like Red Spirit Lake. I didn't love it. I liked it, but I wouldn't recommend anybody buy it. But We Await was awful. 10 left for this one. We Await, awful movie. I don't even like the artwork on this. I don't know that I would want this. But 14 left on this, $40. A new Fun City logo shirt. That's interesting. In pink. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Cannibal Hookers soundtrack. Who put out Cannibal Hookers? Wasn't that Culture Shock?
That was, yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, that movie. Oh my god! Talk about like, I mean, I like the nakedness in it, but like, what's the word? Continuity.
Uh huh.
Is terrible. My god! One minute she has like a shaved head with like ponytails, and the next her hair is longer. And in the next scene, it's like the back to it. It's like, oh my god.
Jesus.
And it's not like they're talking like this is the past or anything. It, oh, that drove me nuts.
It's a Mark of a Donald Farmer film. Cafe Flesh, not my favorite adult film, but it does have its fans. Here it is on soundtrack cassette. I mean, do these sell well? I can't imagine. I guess collectors will buy it.
Yeah. I feel like Vinegar Syndrome, like this is the place where they would sell.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Take Me Somewhere Nice. This was out last month, I believe. This is the vinyl soundtrack. I didn't get that one. And then you can also buy it on VHS for $25. 18 left. Man, how do they decide what gets a VHS and what gets a screen print poster? And I wonder how that works.
It's very random.
It is.
They throw names in a hat. They just maybe. Pick them out.
Tony, I'm sorry. It's limit one per customer, dude.
Damn it.
You're going to have to get some other people to buy you more copies. I don't know. It's interesting. I don't know how many people would actually grab it. I'm curious if anybody in the chat's grabbing it for their like burgeoning VHS reissue collection. Why pink? Why pink? Cafe Flesh? Because it's vagina lips? I don't know. That's always my default.
Why not? Why not pink?
Yeah, it's always my default. Doug D, I put that Franco title in my cart at like 1 p.m. and was like, man, I'll get it later. Yep. And now it's gone forever. You can still get it, by the way, from Pulse. I think it's Pulse Video. It's the French company that put it out. Mm-hmm. They still have it. But you're not going to get the titty slip. That's gone. Or you could get the one that I made. If you guys want to have this, I'll print out copies. You can just glue it to your edition. You know, feel free. I will provide copies for everyone who wants that.
Why did that sell out so quick, though?
Because it was 1,000 copies, a limited slip cover, and there was boobies on it. So I guess that was it. Yeah, well, yeah. Cafe Flesh soundtrack though, 80s MIDI cool jazz. Yeah, not for me, but I'm glad you're into it, JJ.
Yeah.
Cassette collecting is getting bigger in the last couple years. That's interesting. I mean, that bodes well for stuff. The Fun City shirt. Vagina lips. That's why. Because obviously they want to, you know, they're like, yeah.
Vagina, vagina, vagina.
Vagina lips, man. That's the answer. AMC, I'm curious. I know you had a big movie viewing goal at the start of the year, but given your movie project and such, how many have you been able to see? Oh, I do give an update when I do these monthly things. Let me do this real quick. Look at my letterbox. I felt behind, obviously, because making the movie. So I'm not as far as I wanted to be. But right now, as of this year, I'm at 534 movies.
Wow.
I still have to watch less than 500, but my goal is 1,000 by the end. I'm gonna do my best. I'm gonna do my best. I'll do it for you guys. I'll watch movies for you guys. And by the way, actually, that reminds me. I'm 7 week starts because of the sale coming up this Thursday night, and Tony will be here.
Yeah,
I'll be here. On Letterboxd, I'm going to be doing 7 week. Reviewing 2 7 titles that I won't be doing on the channel. So follow me on Letterboxd, link in the description, and I'll give you my thoughts on some 7 titles. And then we'll probably be doing a video releasing before the site closes down saying, hey, this is what you should get from 7 and stuff like that. I'll be able to do that now.
Yeah, I know the movies you've heard, you said it was terrible, but that Master of the World movie.
Oh, yeah.
I went to watch it the other night because I was like, I'm going to watch this. And it wouldn't play in my PlayStation.
Oh, really?
And I'm like, what the hell? So I messaged Vinegar Syndrome about it. And I said, I just opened it up. It won't work. And I also told him about my Rudy Ray Moore box. And I thought, what the hell? Because people are like, message him anyway. Because it was dented on the side. I never say anything. So they're sending me a new disc for Master of the World. And they're also going to send me the lid. They wanted to see pictures of the Rudy Ray Moore one. But I sent it, and they're like, okay, yeah, sure. Would you want just the lid? And I was like, yeah, the lid's fine. Just send that. So good customer service. Right away, they sent it back to me.
They are awesome. Absolutely. Evie, I don't know if Evie is one person or if she's just like an amalgamation of people, but if Evie is real, Evie's amazing. She's amazing customer service for sure.
Oh, yeah. Agreed.
Hey, Cam, what the F? You're a beast. Thank you, sir. It's easy. I just sit down and watch them. It's the easiest thing in the world. But I'm going to do it. I think I'm going to make that happen. I wonder how much the merchandise is about getting scalpers to bite. Possible, but I don't think scalpers would buy t-shirts. I can't imagine that would sell well. Hey, here's buy a t-shirt on eBay for, yeah, I don't know. Do t-shirts sell on eBay? Maybe they do. I don't know.
I think it's if they're old.
Yeah. You know? Yeah.
Like old concert shirts go for like a lot of money.
Right.
But I don't think one of these would.
No, I don't think so. Griff says Evie is an air doll. Oh no! As long as she's alive and nobody pops her, then we'll keep her around. We'll keep her around.
Yeah.
Ray Steckler, is this like another Al Adamson type guy? Yes. 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 And luckily, I've got two lovely subscribers who may be hooking me up with the box set when the time comes. To review the Steckler set, so that'll be great. I'll be whoever gets it first and is willing to send it to me first, I'll get that review up. But speaking of reviews, guess what's coming? It's been shipped. It'll be here hopefully next week, and then after 7 week, I'll start the reviews. That's right, the Eurocrypt of Christopher Lee Part 2.
Oh no!
Oh shit! I'm really scared. But it'll be here, and you know, I'm gonna go in rose-colored glasses and hope for the best. Reviews incoming, and I'll be as soon as it arrives, I'll be reaching out to the subscriber who hooked me up with the box set, and once I'm done reviewing it, I'll send it on to them with a little extra goodie. They get a little. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. He'll know. He gets a sticker and he gets a little extra goodie for being a pal and hooking me up and letting me review it. John, please bring the pain.
Yeah. What if it's better? What if it's good?
If it's good, then I'll say, hey, it's fucking good. 100%. I'm not gonna shit on good shit. If it's good,
yeah. I didn't mean that. I mean just like surprising. Like the first one's so bad, but the second one's good.
I would be very happy to report that and say, guys, get it. I mean, if you like Christopher Lee, he's actually in these movies. So I'll be happy to do that. Gizmo says, what movies will you recommend? I seen Air Doll and I think it was good. Oh, he saw Air Doll. Okay, great. I recommend 100%. I know you're going to love it if you haven't seen it yet. Video Violence 1 and 2. It's a little pricey. So if you want to wait for Black Friday, go ahead. But 100% recommend these movies. And I think Tony agrees.
Mm-hmm. I'm honestly very surprised you like that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I thought you would hate Video Violence.
You know what? I might have if it wasn't for the fact that I had good memories about it, you know, watching with BC and TC. And I don't know. It was a part of our movie watching experience.
Yeah.
And the other thing I would recommend is Sharam Mokri box set here. Some very interesting films. Actually, Gizmo, you might really love it. As a filmmaker yourself, I think you're going to dig these movies. Specifically, Fish and Cat. I don't know if the other ones are shot that way, but Fish and Cat, you're not going to believe me. But this is 100% true. It's a 2.5-hour single-take movie with the camera following the characters around the location. It's amazing. Choreography alone, mind-boggling. So those are the two that I would recommend. Tony, what would you recommend?
Well, definitely Video Violence. Red Lips sounds interesting to me. I don't know. It's probably bad, but Red Lips. It's Michelle Bauer, if you're a fan of Michelle Bauer. And Air Doll definitely has me interested, especially the trailer. It looked pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah, I think.
And then the one you said with that with the single take.
The Mokri movies, yeah.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna drop some cash on Air Doll, Red Lips, because I'm a sucker for boobs. And then the Mowgli box set and Video Violence, which I already purchased. But that's what I'm grabbing for this month. What did you end up grabbing? Pretty much everything?
Just about. Yeah.
You didn't get polystyrene?
No, I didn't get that. and I didn't get that Apocalypse After, and of course that other one from Pulse Video sold out, and I did not get it for. I did not get Forbidden Love.
Yeah, I wish I wish it would, if it was a, you know, if there's a way to watch it, maybe I'll track it down and watch it somewhere. But
I do really like the cover. I like that artwork.
It's great. It's great. Mm. I'm going to hide the boobies, even though I love me some Brigitte. This is the year of Brigitte LeHaye, man. Fuck it. YouTube, check this out. Check that out, YouTube. Oh, yeah. I love Brigitte LeHaye. This is the year of Brigitte LeHaye. You know, Severin's got a ton of her titles. Hopefully, they've got some at their booth. Oh, by the way. Vinegar Syndrome and Severn are going to be at this convention. Mm. And sometimes they have stuff that's out of stock. Namely, the Chauffeur Slip. I know they had it. They've had it. They had it a couple months ago at their table. But I didn't have money on me. So I'm going to grab it. I am going to grab that shit. And I'll be vlogging that. So expect those videos to drop one on Sunday, one on Monday. Unless I do an unboxing. And then it'll be Tuesday. But I'll be doing a two-parter on that. I'll be meeting up with Wet Movie, Disconnected, and OGP. Everybody's going down there. We'll be hanging out.
Cool.
Fett says, Eurocrypt is like Christopher Lee version of Where's Waldo? Yeah. Essentially, yes. Essentially, yes. Nostalgia can make you love the worst kind of crap. I don't know what that is. Ilbibs? I don't know what that is.
It's true, though.
Yeah, I'm excited for the new Subculture 4K. Yeah, I am too. I just hope it's a good movie. We'll have to see.
Yeah.
I have to see if it lives up to its potential. I recommend the Brigitte LeHaye film, even if I haven't seen it. By the way, there are a lot of adult Brigitte LeHaye films on the hub. If you do a search, you'll find a lot of her work. I didn't know she was a porn star until fairly recently. I thought she was just a horror actress that worked with Jean Roland a lot, and then I found out she did porn. And then it's like a whole new world. I felt like Aladdin. You know, don't you dare close your eyes. You know.
Yeah. Right. Well, so Michelle Bauer, she did porn.
I know that was that, but none of her porn that's available is really good. So it's unfortunate, but maybe one day. Mr. Tony, please do a review of Final Flesh when it comes.
Okay.
All right, there you go. You'll have a laughing but very serious. I've never heard that yet. That's a new one on me.
I never heard that.
Okay. John says you can't miss Disconnected. He's so tall. I've heard he's tall. I'm like 5'7", so I'm usually shorter than everybody. I'm like the Tom Cruise of the group.
Which is another one I haven't seen yet. Is Maverick? Oh,
it's good. You know what I liked about it? That it's the first movie where he doesn't really hide that he's the short guy. So like all the other young pilot guys are like towering over him.
Yeah,
but I like that. I think that there's an honesty there to his performance that you don't see in a lot of his work. So I did appreciate that.
Cool.
Okay, partner label month. That's it. You can of course still. Just by partner labeled titles on the site. Vinegar Syndrome titles have been pulled off. Mm-hmm. Ugh. Warning, do not get this. So bad. I couldn't believe how bad that was. And Backwoods Marcy. Jesus. Oh, God. No. I can go into details, but I won't. Anyway, so you can only buy partner label titles for this month. But remember, June 10th, you do get $10 if you use that $5 coupon that they offered. So I would suggest buying something then. If you're going to get the box set, wait for June 10th. Tony didn't, but I'm waiting.
I didn't get a coupon. Like the $5 thing.
You didn't use that? Okay.
No, I was going to wait. I already pretty much got everything I wanted. And then gotcha. Later, I was going to use it later on at night. And then I forgot about it. And when I looked, it was like 12:21. I was like, well, can't use it now. So I missed out. But it's all right.
You know what? Now that I look at it, there's a new code. So I actually get $12.50 off. So yeah. So I think I'll grab it.
That and the video violence.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if the 4K was that code or not, but yeah, just make sure you don't screw yourself.
Absolutely. It's a sub 50.
I know that one's sub 50.
So I think I'm just going to I'm gonna wait, because usually sub 50 is $8 off. That's what you get. Yeah. It's technically five, 50% off, but it's really $8 off. So I'm going to wait and use the $10 on maybe AirDoll. Yeah, I'll probably do AirDoll. Yeah, why not?
Can you only use that during this, or can you save it?
I don't know. We haven't gotten it yet. So I'm guessing on June 10th, they might say only good for this month, so you have to use it.
Only good for this month. It's half gone.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, if there's anything that's super limited and you really want to grab it now, but stuff like Red Lips and AirDoll will hang out. And these will hang out for sure until Black Friday. I'm 100% that'll happen. Alrighty. I think I've said all my announcements. Monsterpalooza next tomorrow. So videos coming for Sunday and Monday or Tuesday. Unboxing. Hopefully the Vinegar Syndrome halfway will be this week. And then I will say... maybe Wednesday I'll release a Severin video. Maybe, Tony, if you'd like to join us for that, a recommendations video. And then Thursday is the big dance, and hope the Severin website holds out. Mm-hmm. if not, we'll just be staring at a blank screen, just talking to each other.
Yeah.
That'll be part of the fun. That's always part of the fun. I hope you guys will join us for that. John says, watched Dark Tower after the halfway streams. During the first 20 minutes, I thought you may have been a bit harsh, but the nothingness that followed led me to change my tune, anticipating a future 8K. Yes. See, everyone thinks I'm honest. And if it sucks, it sucks. And I, as a filmmaker, I expect that to happen in my movies. That's why I don't watch reviews of my movies.
Oh, you don't?
I don't. I mean, unless somebody tells me, hey, this is a good review of it, I'll watch that. But usually I don't. I don't read reviews. I stay away. Because that gives me the freedom to be free to review movies, you know? I don't want to say, well, you know, I don't want to be mean. But art is art. Everybody interprets art a different way, you know? Yeah. Art, the movies I make at the level of money I make and the time I have to make them, I know they're not perfect, but, you know, I still want the movie to be judged as its own art piece, and it's as you experience it, no matter what. You shouldn't know that it took me 6 days to make a movie. It shouldn't matter to you.
No.
And it doesn't matter to me if Dark Star had a better plot. They couldn't afford a monster to the last day of shooting.
Dark Tower.
Yeah, what did I say?
Dark Star.
John says, I'm 5'7", and casually came up to his shoulders. Nice. I'll be aware of that. I watched Coca-Cola Kid on Tubi. So did I. It's a weird watch until you realize it's a low-key critique of capitalism. Yeah, it's an okay movie. It's a one-time watch for me. Bikini says, you didn't like Wicked World? I gave it a 4 out of 5 on Letterboxd. Yikes!
Well, I get to watch it.
I'm glad you enjoyed that one. Nathan, I would suggest a TVYB, although for me it's a solid purchase only because I know the film and I have good memories of it.
I want to know when we're going to review this.
Oh, man.
I have it still sealed. I didn't even open it yet.
You know what? Maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll do that. I haven't seen that. I haven't seen mine either. They're back here. We'll talk. We'll talk off air. Maybe we'll make that happen.
All right.
All right. I got to hop off, gang. Who's coming to the 7th sale panel? Tony will be there. BC will be there. Mel has graciously returned.
Yeah.
And that's all that I can announce at the moment.
I'm excited for the Severin sale.
Yeah, we'll see. They still haven't announced anything, which is kind of odd. They're being very quiet about their. I mean, they're never secretive about what they're releasing. So it's kind of interesting that they're being very quiet. I'm actually hoping Severin has some sale titles. At their booth tomorrow. We'll see. I will report back if I find something.
Cool.
No good. Resistance kicked ass from Saturn's core. Interesting. TBYB for me.
Well, that might be here tomorrow. We'll see.
Oh, nice. I have had viewers on the panel before, but only Patreon people. That's a perk I throw my supporters, because YouTube does not let me monetize. They announced 4? What's the other title they announced? I know they did All About Evil, the two Brigitte LaHaye movies. What's the other one? What's the most recent one? Hmm. Drop it in the comments. I did not see that. Oh, they announced Blood Hunt. What the fuck is Blood Hunt?
I don't know. Blood Hunt.
Oh, come on. You're going to give me the shits?
Severin will do that.
I'm signing into Twitter here so I can pull it up and see if we can talk about Blood. A Spanish horror film from 1985. Okay, I missed that. I was on the twits.
Ooh, chill.
Let's see.
Someone just walked on my grave.
Oh, you got a chill?
Yeah.
Hey, look! Yay, Volume 2. did they not announce it on Twitter? Oh, here we go. Time to share another mid-year sale title. This time, it's a disc debut of Blood Hunt. That sounds fucking good. Original and effective, it combines kinky with the rural thriller genre where hostile villagers live with unspeakable secrets.
Hmm.
Oh, man.
That's a cool cover.
Don't fall for the cover, folks.
I know.
That was a slip? That's fucking cool. That does look really good, actually.
Yeah.
Blood Hunt. Fuck, that does sound good. I'll have to do some research on that one.
Mm-hmm.
Blood Hunt. Fuck yeah. Okay.
Is that other one, Natasha Leone, is that they're putting that out too?
Yeah. And that's going to be on, and that's going to be on Shudder though. So I would TBYB on that one, but that's just me.
I like her too. Like I think she's a good actress.
She is good. She is very good. And she's a big fan of genre cinema and movies. Like she was one of the people who supported financially the Out of the Blue restoration.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's like one of her favorite movies, and so she was responsible for a lot of that work.
Well, that's cool. So you should see if you can get her on.
It's possible. She's worked with the Asylum before, which is interesting. It'd be cool. Maybe it's possible. We'll see what happens. I'm working on a thing to get some cool folks on, but I'm trying to worry about editing right now before I get.
Oh
on.
Yeah, editing. Oh shit. Good luck with that.
Thank you. Yes. it's stressful, but it's part of the fun of filmmaking at this level. You just gotta do what you gotta do. All right, Tony. Thank you for joining me, sir.
No, thank you. Thank you for having me always.
And folks at home, thank you for watching. I appreciate that. Remember, do me a favor and drop a thumbs up if you had a good time. Only if you had a good time. And I hope you did. And I hope you'll come back. And I'll see you next time at a convention. Wet Movie will be with me. And hopefully we'll team up with Disconnected. And OGP will be there Sunday. So he'll be in the second part of that. We're meeting the Screamcast. I don't know how much I can film with them. Maybe I can, you know, Jamie Kennedy doesn't have a big line. It seems like he's down to talk on camera.
I was going to say, I think he'd be like, he might even hang out with you.
Yeah, that'd be great. I mean, he's definitely and he's friends with Brendan. At least he's hung out with him twice, so it might be a chance to chat with Randy Meeks himself. How fucking cool is that?
Yeah.
All right, my friends. Let me know in the comments what you picked up if we haven't chatted here. But until we meet again, I love you. I love you just the way you are.
Yeah. Y'all ready for this?